Today's topic is antepartum hemorrhage, and we shall discuss definition of antepartum hemorrhage, importance of antepartum hemorrhage, causes, management and prognosis of antepartum hemorrhage. Now, bleeding in pregnancy. When bleeding occurs during pregnancy, if it occurs before pregnancy, this is known as antepartum hemorrhage. If it is occurring after pregnancy, known as postpartum hemorrhage, or if it is bleeding in early pregnancy. So antepartum hemorrhage is bleeding from vagina during pregnancy from 24th week of gestation. Gestational age to term is known as antepartum hemorrhage. When hemorrhage occurs from 24th week of gestation is known as antepartum hemorrhage. Now, epidemiology of antepartum hemorrhage occurs 3-5% of all pregnancies, 3 times more common in multiparous women than primiparous women. So it occurs 24th week of gestation. Importance, what is the importance of the antepartum hemorrhage? It is obstetric emergency, and it is a dangerous condition because fetus can be miscarried. So antepartum hemorrhage is obstetric emergency, and it can lead to deep vein thrombosis, and management reduces risk of premature delivery, and maternal morbidity and mortality depends upon the bleeding. What are the causes of antepartum hemorrhage? Antepartum hemorrhage causes are blood stained. It shows most common cause of antepartum hemorrhage. Placental abruption can be there. What is placental abruption? When placenta is at abnormal size. Placenta previa, second most common pathological cause, are vasa previa, often difficult to diagnose. Uterine rupture can be there for antepartum hemorrhage. Now, bleeding from lower genital tract. When bleeding occurs, it may be cervical bleeding because of cervicitis, because of cervical neoplasia, cervical polyp can be there, cervical ectropion can be there, or vaginal bleeding occur because trauma, neoplasia, vulvar varices and infections. So whenever bleeding from vagina occurs, there may be different causes as well, but if it is occurring 24th week before gestation, 24th week of gestation, so it may be labeled as antepartum hemorrhage. There may be inherited disease, bleeding disease like thrombothyrosemia and clotting factor defects. Bleeding rate may confuse the vaginal bleeding, like GI bleeding can be there, hemorrhoids, inflammatory bowel disease, and UTI patient presence with bleeding. So physician should diagnose that what type of bleeding is there. Placenta previa. Now, placenta previa, as I already mentioned, that insertion of placenta partially or fully in the lower segment of the uterus. Now look at this picture. Placenta is placed here in normal position, while in this figure placenta is placed here. So this is abnormal position because here is the uterus and placenta is present here. Baby has no way to come out because placenta is implanted here. So it is obstetric emergency as well, and a placenta is present at a lower segment of uterus, which is known as placenta previa. What are the etiological factors of placenta previa? Etiological factors are endometrial factors like a scarred endometrium, curettage of several time, abnormal uterus. Are placental factors like large placenta, abnormal formation of the placenta, developmental retardation of fertilized egg. So these are the causes, etiological factors of placenta previa. Risk factors: multiparous women are more prone to develop placenta previa, advanced maternal age, and prior LSCs or other uterine surgery. Prior placenta previa can contribute to placenta previa. Uterine structural anomaly or assisted conception can develop placenta previa. Degrees of placenta previa. What are the degrees of placenta previa? Stage 1, stage 2, stage 3 and stage 4. In stage 1, as you can see, placenta is present slightly at the slight side of uterus, and in stage 2, placenta is approximately there in the opening of the uterus. In stage 3, it a half of the placenta covers uterine opening, and in stage 4, full placenta is present in lower segment of uterus. So there is a name known as contemporary, marginal, lateral, central placenta previa. So these are different stages of the placenta previa. Classification in grade 1, when placenta encroaches lower segment but does not reach the cervix. In grade 2, when placenta reaches the cervix but os does not cover it. In grade 3, some part of placenta covers the os. And in grade 4, complete placenta covering the os. So this is known as placenta previa. Placenta previa clinical features should be recurrent painless vaginal bleeding, abdominal finding like uterus is soft in placenta previa, and contraction may be palpated. Presenting part is high, abnormal presentation, maternal cardiovascular compromises will be there. Vaginal examination should not be done in placenta previa. What examination should be performed in placenta previa? Examinations will be transvaginal ultrasound and ultrasound which shows lower segment of uterus, and transvaginal ultrasound is performed and leading edge within 2 cm internal os and completely covering the vaginal delivery. Now, complications. What can be complications of the placenta previa? Maternal complications like major hemorrhage can be there, shock can be there, death can be there, it is medical emergency, renal tubular necrosis can be there because of hemorrhage, postpartum hemorrhage can be there, morbidity adherent placenta can be there, patient will become anemic because of hemorrhage, hypovolemia and shock and eventually will lead to death, sensitization of the mother and disseminated intravascular coagulation can be there. Placenta previa is fetal causes, fetal complications can be intrauterine, death can be there, hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy to the fetus because fetus will get less blood supply to the brain, cerebral palsy, mental retardation, placental abruption and premature labor can occur to the fetus. So the next topic is placental abruption. We will discuss in next video placental abruption.